We do worship a great and awesome God. Take your Bibles and let's turn together to the book of Genesis. We're finished with Christmas, even though the Christmas trees are all lit up. We're going to be thinking this morning about the new year. There's a brand new year. 2014 is just around the corner. Can you imagine that? I mean, where has the year gone? The older I get, the faster time seems to move. It just seems like yesterday we were doing a New Year's service for 2013. And now 2013's coming to a close. It's pretty amazing when you stop and you think about it. There's a brand new year out there. All kinds of possibilities. All kinds of potential. We just don't have any idea what it's going to look like. I mean, we make New Year's resolutions. We think about the future. You know, is the economy going to turn around? Am I going to maintain my health in the new year? Will I live to see 2015? I mean, there's all kinds of questions that come to mind when you start thinking about New Year's. When you start looking at the road ahead. You know, sometimes the road looks troubling. It looks kind of rocky. Looks kind of scary. Betsy and I just got back from visiting with Jordan out in L.A. He graduated this past week. And so we fly into LAX and get on the bus and we go to the car rental place. And then I have the experience of a lifetime. I get to drive on Los Angeles freeways. That can be a pretty scary kind of event. You know, not knowing exactly when to turn, where to turn, what to do. You know, you can be in this center lane and your turn's coming up and you're eight lanes over from where you need to be. And then the freeways all come together and it looks like a big spider web. And you don't know when you turn the corner, am I going to be involved in a police chase? You know, you see the helicopters on TV and the cars running and maybe somebody will shoot guns at us while we're coming through the LA. You know, how are we going to get through all of this mess? It's quite a challenge. The road ahead is always a challenge. 2014 is a challenge as it lays out before us. None of us know, is it going to be smooth? Is it going to be rocky? What's around the corner? Are we going to run into one of those traffic jams that will bring us to a complete stop? What's out there? Well, here's the good news. The good news is that there is hope in the new year. There is hope in the year that is coming. There is hope for me and hope for you. That the new year, no matter how rocky it may be, no matter how good or how bad it may be, there is still hope because of the God that we serve. In the book of Genesis, in the 28th chapter, there is a story of a young man who goes on a journey. He gets on a road that's kind of rocky. In fact, it's so rocky that when it comes time to take a nap, he lays down to go to bed and he uses a rock for a pillow. Now, I like hard pillows. But I don't think I want to sleep on a rock. But when he goes to sleep, he discovers that on this rocky road that's ahead of him, he finds God. And it gives him a sense of hope, and it gives me a sense of hope that no matter what's coming down the road, I can have hope in the new year. Repeat this after me. I have hope in the new year. Let's try that one more time. I have hope in the new year. If we begin this day with hope in the new year, we can understand that God will bring us to that destination. When Betsy and I were driving down through LA, one of the good things was I took a GPS unit with me. And so no matter when I made those bad turns, and I did, when I got off at the wrong exit, and I did, and I got to tell you, when you get off the wrong exit in LA, it's a little different than getting off the wrong exit going to I-70. You know, when you go down two lanes and you get off the wrong exit, you just go around and get back on and go the other direction a little bit, and you make it fine. But when you're talking eight lanes of traffic and three or four interstates coming together, it becomes a little more complicated than that. But I had a GPS unit with me. And when I got on that GPS unit and I made the wrong turn, that GPS was always giving me corrective advice. It was always saying, recalculating. You guys know what I mean. Some of you have been there. You know what I'm talking about. And it would get me back on the right word, the right road. It would take me ultimately to my destination. Here's Jacob. We call this the story of Jacob's ladder. It's really not the story of Jacob's ladder. It's the story of the Lord's ladder. Because it's not exclusively intended for him. And I'm going to prove that to you in just a few minutes. But what we discover in his account, in his story, is that he had hope on an unknown road that was ahead, and you and I can have hope in the unknown road that is ahead of us. Jacob, think about him. He legally had the rights to everything his father had. He was a wealthy young man. He was on a journey because he was of marrying age and there was no prospects where he was. He was looking for a new wife. And he started on a trip down a road he'd never been on to a place he'd never seen to find a woman that he knew he had to find, but he didn't know what she looked like. And yet in this process, he discovers hope for the journey. I have hope in the new year. Repeat it after me. I have hope for the new year. All right. Genesis chapter 28, verse 10 and following. Are you there? Hold your Bibles up when you found it. We have a word of hope for the new year. Listen to what it says. Now Jacob went out from Beersheba and he went toward Haran. And he came to a certain place and he stayed there all night because the sun had set. And he took one of the stones of that place and he put it at his head and he laid down in that place to sleep. Then he dreamed. And behold, a ladder was set up on the earth, and its top reached to the heavens. And there the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie I will give to you and your descendants. Also your descendants shall be as the dust of the earth, and you will spread abroad to the west and the east and the north and the south. And in you and in your seed, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. That's a reference to us. In his seed, all the families of the earth, that's part of us, we're going to be blessed. Behold, verse 15, I am with you and will keep you. Wherever you go, I will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have spoken to you. Then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. He was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. Then Jacob rose early in the morning, and he took the stone that he had put at his head, and he set it up as a pillar, and he poured oil on top of it, and he called the name of that place Bethel, the house of God. Previously, it had been named, the city had been named Luz previously. And Jacob made a vow saying, if God will be with me and keep me in this way that I am going and give me bread to eat and clothing to put on so that I come back to my father's house in peace, then the Lord will be my God. And this stone which I've set as a pillar shall be God's house. And of all that you give me, surely I will give you a tenth to you. What a great story. What a great account. He encounters God and he didn't even know it. But what we discover is that on that rocky, unknown road that Jacob traveled down, there was hope. And on whatever road you and I have to take in 2014, no matter what lies out before us, no matter what possibilities, what potential, what problems that we may face, there is hope in the new year. There is hope in 2014. I have hope for my life. I have hope for my church. I have hope for my family. I have hope for my friends in the new year. Repeat it after me. I have hope in the new year. So think about it with me for just a minute. Think about this, a word of hope for 2014. The first thing that we discover is that my faith can flourish on the unknown road ahead. Here was Jacob. He had left his father. He was separated from his family. The last thing his brother said to him was, if I catch you, I'm going to kill you. And yet he is on this unknown, rocky road. It's going to be difficult. It's not always going to be perfect. It's not going to be a bed of roses. It's not going to be smooth all the time. But what we discover is that his faith began to take off and it begins to grow as he's on this journey. If Jacob's faith can grow under those kinds of circumstances, then my faith certainly can grow in the year that is to come. No matter how rocky the road may be, my faith can flourish. And your faith can flourish if we meet God on that road. See, that was the key for Jacob. Jacob met the true and the living God on that particular road. Jacob he had all the legal power. He had all the money, all the rights to the family wealth. He was a mama's boy. And yet he was sent on a journey, on a road he'd never been on, to a place he'd never seen. He was on the road. And it was on that journey that he met God. Let me tell you, 2014 may hold a lot of things for a lot of people. But one of the things that I do know is that anyone can meet God in the year to come. There is no one beyond the realm of meeting with the true and the living God, of rediscovering Him, of nurturing our faith in Him, of growing in that faith, of meeting Him for the very first time. No matter what the road ahead holds, our faith can flourish in the new year. There was no going back. Now, you got to think about Jacob. I mean, he's on this trip. He's left his family. Jacob, let's be honest, he was a mama's boy. He was not equipped to go camping, to live off the land, which is what it describes here for us. His brother Esau, he was the deer hunter of the family. Jacob, he knitted and cross-stitched. That's what he did. He was not the guy that should be on this journey to nowhere, this unknown road. He was not the guy of discovery, and yet he made the greatest discovery of all because he met God on this journey. There is hope for me that my faith can flourish in the new year. 2014 stretches out before us, and from this place that I stand, it looks a little rocky. But every new year looks rocky. Every new year is unknown. Every new year has its own secrets and the hidden things that we're going to be facing. But the truth is, I can have hope in the new year because I can develop my faith in God. I can deepen my walk with Him. I can encounter Him on the journey. So this is my word to you. I have hope in the new year. Repeat it after me. I have hope in the new year. Second thing. One of the things that we discover, not only can my faith flourish on this unknown road, but God will be bigger than anything I face on the road ahead. Do you notice what happens here in this story? He lays down and dreams a dream. And behold, there was a ladder set up on the earth, and its top reached to the heavens. And the angels of God were ascending and descending upon it. And the Lord, listen to it, and the Lord stood above it. That's a powerful truth. We often read that and we overlook it. That is significant. It was the angels that used the ladder. It was the angels of God that came to minister to the people on the earth. They came up and down on the ladder, but not the Lord. The Lord stood above it. He was bigger than the heavens, and He was bigger than the earth. He was bigger than anything that Jacob would meet on the road. Listen, I don't know what you're going to meet in the new year. I don't know what things you're going to encounter. I don't know what kind of problems you're going to have, what kind of victories you're going to see. But I know this, that my God is bigger than anything you're going to encounter. He is above everything that you're going to face. This ladder that's found here, it teaches us that God is not limited and confined to a place or a location. He's much bigger than that. He describes Himself and shows Himself to Jacob as being the God of the heavens and the God of the earth. Listen, there's nothing you're going to face in this new year that God's not bigger than. There is no sickness, there is no illness, there is no disaster, there is no storm, there is no problem that you come upon. There is no rock on the road ahead that is too big for our God. He is bigger. He stands above all of those things. I love the analogy. Jacob dreamed a dream. Listen, nothing you dream up will be larger than God. Nothing I dream up can be bigger than God. I have hope in the new year because I serve and worship a big God. A God that stands above everything that I will face on the road called life. The road ahead is full of hope because my God is bigger than anything I will face. Repeat it again. My God is bigger than anything I face. Now you know, I'm not telling you that if you get sick, God is going to automatically heal you. I'm not telling you that everybody in this room is going to live to 2015. That may not be the case, but what I do know is this, that my God is bigger, and He will bring us to that final destination, that He will honor His word, and He will see us through the rocky road that is ahead. Because He's bigger than anything we're going to meet on this road. My faith can flourish. My God is bigger. Third thing that we discover, God has promised to protect me on the road ahead. He promised Jacob, I'm going to be with you and I'm going to protect you. What I understand is this, that God doesn't promise to take the rocks out of the road and make it smooth. He promises to go with me through that process. He promises to walk with me every step of the way. Listen to what he says. Behold, I am with you. I will keep you wherever you go. I will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I've done for you what I've spoken to you. God didn't promise Jacob that he's going to take all the rocks away. What he said was, I'll be with you in the process and I'll bring you back to where you need to be. That was the great thing about having a GPS unit. You know, I kind of like those things. When I'm in a strange place and don't know where I'm going and I can plug in an address, I knew that if I put in the right information, that thing would give me the right advice. And it did. When I made a wrong turn, that thing was that quiet voice that kept saying, correcting. Take the next left. Take the next left. Take the next left. Take the next left. I mean, it just kept telling me to get, but I knew this, if I kept listening, if I was in tune to the voice, it would bring me back. It would take me to that final destination. I would get where I needed to go. That's what God promises Jacob, and that is the promise that God has given to me. My road ahead may not be perfect, it may not be smooth, it may be very rocky, but the road ahead is full of hope because God will lead us through it. I know in 2014, my leadership skills are going to be tested. I know my abilities and my gifts are going to be stretched. I've told you before, listen, this church has outgrown me a long time ago. I don't know. God just keeps letting me stay here and do this stuff, and I'm having a great time doing it. But you know what? It's not about me. I'm going to be tested in the new year. But I know this, my God will see me through. One way or another, He will see me through it all. And I know that you will be tested in the new year, that you're going to face some rocky times and some difficult moments. You're going to face those times when it seems like your faith has come to that traffic jam of life and it's going to seem to stop. You're going to find those times when you're going to feel like the police are chasing you and you don't know what to do. And there's going to be those times when you feel like you've gotten off track. But I'm here to tell you that there is hope in the new year because God has promised to be with us. Jesus Himself said, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. There is hope in the new year. Because of who our God is. Repeat it after me. I have hope in the new year. I have hope in the new year because my faith can flourish on the unknown road ahead. I have hope in the new year because my God will be bigger than anything I face on this unknown road ahead. I have faith in the new year. I have hope in the new year because God has promised to protect me on that road that is ahead. Number four, fourth thing. I have hope in the new year because God is always present on the road ahead, even when I don't know it. I love what happens in the story. Jacob wakes up from his sleep and he said, God was here, I didn't even know it. I love that. Let me tell you something this morning. God is here. You may not know it. You may go, you know what? I don't like that preacher very much. Big deal. Wake up. God is here. You don't have to know me. Oh, I don't like the songs they sing at that church. Wake up. God is here. I don't like the person I'm sitting at. Well, I can understand that one, but No, wake up! It doesn't matter who you're sitting by. God is here. There is no place that you can flee from His presence. There is no place that you can go. When you go to work, He is there. When you go to school, He is there. When you go to church, He is there. It doesn't matter whether you sense His presence, whether you feel His presence, whether you understand what He's doing. That doesn't matter. Wake up because God is here. Here's old Jacob. He's made his journey. He's on that rocky, unknown road. He goes to sleep, and when he awakens, he realizes that God was in that place, and he didn't even know it. You'd be surprised the places that God turns up. You'd be surprised the places where God is present. God was at that rocky place before Jacob got there. God was there on that road, that rocky, unknown road, before Jacob ever showed up. Let me tell you, I don't know what 2014 holds for you. Good or bad. Sickness, health, riches or poverty. I don't know what's out there. But I know this, God is already there. He will get there before you. It may take you by surprise, but it will never take Him by surprise. That everything that happens to you, He either lets it happen, allows it to happen, or causes it to happen. Because our God is that big. Because our God is that good. Our God is that great. Our God is always present on the road ahead, even when we don't sense it. Even when we don't feel it. You ever been in that situation where you pray and you pray and you feel like your prayers go up about to the ceiling and then they fall back to the ground? Let me tell you something. God was still there. God is in that place. Here's Jacob in the backside of nowhere. He's on a rocky, dusty, unknown road, and he lays down and puts his head on a rock for a pillow. He goes to sleep, and he encounters God in his dream, and when he awakens, this is what he says. God was here, didn't even know it. Let me tell you, wherever you go, God is there, whether you know it or not. There's hope for the new year. There's hope in 2014 for me and for you, for our church, for our family, for our nation, for our friends, because God is there. And where God is, there's the possibility for life. God is there. When Jacob realized that God was there, he began to worship. Man, he set up an altar and he poured oil on it and he anointed the place and he said, "Truly, this is the dwelling place of God. Bethel, house of God." What a great story. We ought to worship and celebrate because God has given us hope for the new year that He will be there, present, with us, protecting us, growing us, that He'll be bigger than anything we can face. I know, you read the story though and you say, but preacher, that story is about Jacob. What does that have to do with me? Well, it's really interesting. When Jesus began to call His disciples, according to John chapter 1, He meets a young man named Nathanael, the friend of Philip. And this guy, Nathanael, the friend of Philip, when he hears that Philip says that we've discovered the Messiah, he's from Nazareth, Nathanael can't believe it. Nothing good can come out of Nazareth. And Jesus encounters Nathanael and says, "You know what? I saw you when you were talking to Philip under the tree. Here comes a man in whom there is no deceit." That's the word that's used there. It's really interesting because what Jesus does is he calls us back to this story. Deceit. That's the word Jacob meant, deceit. Deceiver. And Jesus said this. When Jesus said, "Here is a man with no deceit," Nathanael says, "You are the Son of God." He said, "You believe because I saw you under the tree? Let me tell you, you will see," listen to this, "the angels of God going up and down on the ladder." I don't even use the word ladder. Take your Bibles, turn with me. You got to see this. You got to understand the key. You see, number five is the key is that Jesus is the key to the road that is ahead. He is the key to everything that we're talking about. He is the key to our faith flourishing. He is a key to our God being bigger than anything that we encounter. He is the key to God promising to protect and to be with us. He is the key to God being present on the road even when we don't see it. John chapter 1, verse 43, are you there? Hold your Bibles up when you found it. We're going to wrap it up right here. I want you to get this. Jesus is the key to hope in the road ahead. Listen to what it says. "The following day, Jesus wanted to go to Galilee," beginning in verse 43, "and He found Philip, and He said to him, 'Follow me.' Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, 'We have found Him of whom Moses in the law and also in the prophets wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph.' And Nathanael said to him, 'Can any good thing come out of Nazareth?' And Philip said, 'Come and see.' And Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward Him and said, 'Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom there is no deceit.'" That harkens us back to Jacob. Listen to this. Keep reading. Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" And Jesus answered and said to him, "Before Philip called you, I saw you when you were under the fig tree. I saw you." Nathanael answered and said to him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." And Jesus answered and said to him, "Because I said to you, I saw you under the fig tree, do you believe? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Most assuredly, I say to you, hereafter," listen to this, "you will see the heavens open and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." Let me tell you a secret. You know who Jacob saw when he saw the ladder? He saw Jesus. His hope was not in a ladder that was built by the hands of men. His hope was not in a religion that came out of the ideas of men. His hope was not in a preacher or a pastor or a church. His hope was in the person of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the Savior of the world. You and I can have hope in 2014 because the key is Jesus. He is the ladder. He is that connecting point between the heavens and the earth. He is the connecting point between my life and my Heavenly Father. He is that connecting point that you and I so desperately need. In 2014, all of the things that happened to Jacob can come true for me. My faith can flourish if I am connected to the connecting point, Jesus Christ. My God will be bigger than anything that I face if my connection is there through the person of Jesus Christ. What I can discover is that God's promise to protect me on the road ahead, it will be intact if I'm connected to His Son, Jesus Christ. And what I've discovered is that God is always present with me because my faith is growing in Him because of my connection to Him. The key is Jesus. The key is Jesus. You know, the older I get, the more I realize that this old body's wearing out. I don't know what 2014 is going to bring. I know I did two funerals yesterday and preaching twice today. It starts to take a toll as you get older. My voice begins to crack. The gray on my hair begins to pop out. I didn't have gray hair when I came here. Okay, maybe a little. But what I know is this. The one who will see me through is not a medical doctor downtown. The one who will bring me to my destination is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. It's the ladder upon which the angels of God ascend and descend. It is the connecting point between the earth and the heavens. It is the person of Jesus Christ. I have hope in the future, in 2014 and beyond, because I know no matter what comes my way, my faith in God can flourish. I know that no matter what comes my way, my God is bigger. He stands above and apart from everything that's going on. I know that my God has promised to protect and to keep to the very end that my eternal security is safe with Him. I know that He's promised to be with me, even when I don't feel it. And I know the key is the person of Jesus Christ. I have hope in 2014. And my prayer is that you do as well. So how can we develop hope in 2014? Three things have to happen. Number one, you must accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. If you want to be in connection with God, you've got to be connected to the ladder. You see, this wasn't just a story about Jacob. This was a story about all of us. Jesus made that clear when He spoke to Nathanael and said, "You're going to see the angels of God coming up and down on the Son of Man." Talking about Himself. Jesus said, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one gets to the Father but by Me." There's the ladder. There's the connecting point. For me to get to God, for me to be in His family, for me to be forgiven of my sins, I've got to be connected through the only way that God has provided. Secondly, I've got to commit myself to following. I have to make a choice. I have to make a decision. Jacob made a decision to worship God. Jacob made a decision to commit himself to God. He made that decision. I have to make the same kind of decision. And then lastly, I have to trust Him to transform me. Oh, you got to study the story of Jacob. Jacob's name means the cheat, the supplanter. But because he met God on this rocky, unknown road, God began the process of transforming his life. Because he saw the ladder, his name would be changed from the cheat to the Prince of God. We call him Israel. That's the new name he was given. What a powerful story. See, I have hope in 2014 because God can continue to change my life. He can continue to transform me from who I am to who I need to be. There is hope in the new year. There is hope in 2014. I have hope in the new year because I have hope in Him. Would you bow with me?